Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Yes, we are continuing with homebrew equipment. I mean, this is really cool. What exactly is this? I have no idea yet, but it looks like somebody built maybe a frequency counter into a case that was originally a satellite receiver, right? Something with what, Sky Raider or something from Oak. Maybe this is a satellite receiver. Oh, it's really, really dirty. So I should probably clean this up a little bit more before I play with this, because I'm gonna get real dirty. Yeah, so this is a satellite receiver, or the case was. Of course, we can see this is input C and input A, and then there's another B and C and another. We got quite a lot of connectors here, and I don't know exactly what is what here. And the power cable is melted real badly. I can actually see metal here and stuff, so I think I should just cut this and try and power it up and see what happens. What exactly is this thing? So this one just clickety clickety click, and maybe this is on and off. Three settings here, and I don't know, a lot of settings here. So what exactly is this thing? So far, no idea. Oh, look at the cutting here. Really? I mean, I am not super impressed, but you know, making square holes or rectangular holes like this is really not easy. I think it's better if we just open this first and see what happens before I blow something up or take the fuses here or something. So we are inside this fantastic unit. I mean, you gotta start somewhere, right? And someone is obviously closer to zero than others. Oh, look at the level. I mean, really? So I guess this is a kit from 1987. And here's the name, AE7216. So I gotta Google this and see what I can come up with. So we got some inputs and we got some stuff. So I guess this is a frequency counter, right? So this is driving the LEDs, and here we got with a counter and driver and all that stuff. But weird, really? Look at all the text and everything here on this board. And it looks just like a proto board, but then add all the silk screens and stuff, and then a prototype board. I really want to see this board on the other side. And that is probably the power supply from the original satellite receiver, just cut out and reused. So that is good for the environment. Let's reuse stuff. This is a very popular. And this is an upgrade made in 1988. Now let's move that one. See? 1988. So this is called AE506. Something with 4 gigahertz prescaler. So it's probably that one that is doing the prescaling, right? And then we got some inverters and a counter. Okay. So that will be the fast input, and we got some other inputs and outputs and stuff here. Also, look at the crystal. 9.76 something. Really? That is weird. That should be a 10 megahertz, right? But I think we should just power it up and see if it takes the fuses. So that is what we're gonna do right now. Here we go. I saw it blink. That's not funny. Let's try and turn it off. Yes, definitely. See? Every time I turn it on, pow. There is something going on here, so I definitely need to repair this first before we can play with it. How typical is that? So this is the bottom of the PCB. So yeah, it looks like a proto board from the top, but here on the bottom it's, yeah, something between a proto board and a ready-made PCB for something, right? You could definitely play around with a lot of modifications. But here you find a twin 10 megahertz crystal. Oh, and this is the power supply input. What you see here is a little bit interesting. That wire is soldered directly to the output of that one. So they're just running in parallel. As far as I know, it's not good practice to to input something on its output. So this one should have been removed. But what I'm going to do is measure if we got 5 volts on the input. So that is a good place to start. So now this thing is actually up and running. It is alive. I'm still trying to figure out how everything is working. So this is what, 0.8? Is this my input? I'm trying to input something here on one of the inputs. I'm not having a lot of luck trying to figure out all the different features. But it is definitely doing, oi, that is 1.2 something, right? Let me see if I, no, this is not my input. Now I can change the readout. And I can also count and do God knows what, faster and slower. Anyway, I think it works, but I don't know exactly what it is measuring and what is the input and what is the what God knows what. It says something here on the PCB. Let me see, maybe that will help. How about, yeah, I need to Google this and see if I can figure this out. And now I'm using the prescaler with a 100 megahertz signal, and this input, I can only make it work in reciproc mode. So that means this is 100 megahertz. Let's see what happens if I go to 101, 102. See what I'm saying? So it's measuring the time. So this is 99, 98 megahertz. There's just absolutely no way. I've been through all the different switches here and I don't know what kind of modes, and then it goes. What kind of junk is this? I don't know. So this is only the resolution thing. I actually managed to get this thing working. So this is 1 megahertz input. And the thing is, if I go 1.1 megahertz input, it's like this. So that is due to the wrong crystal. And it can do time mode, frequency modes, and all sorts of different modes here by dialing around with all this. It's just insanely difficult to use when you don't know what is actually what is what. Oh man, this is a lot of fun and a really, really weird kit. This is the timer chip, ICM7216, that is on this board. And the data sheet was real easy to find online. And it explains all the features there's in this chip. Let's go to the, let's see if I can zoom out a little bit. So yes, this is a complete frequency counter with AB logic and period time and all that stuff. Let's see. It goes to 10 megahertz on input A and 2.5 megahertz on input B. Okay. And the oscillator is, yeah, 10 megahertz. So that is all great. I think I found some real good design examples down here in the, yeah, this is how it's all connected and blah, 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 blah. We're borrowing. Yeah, here we go. So this is yeah, just your function generators for input A and input B. So just this data sheet here is really, really old and it is just not very well explained the way that it is drawn here. But the idea is, that will be the display selector bits. And of course, they're not connected together like this. This is just supposed to be an 8-bit bus. And of course, it goes to some transistor drivers, so you can probably select the individual digits. And that will be the segment drivers for the 7 segments. So those display selector bits, they can go to some switches or some diodes. In this case, they are go via diodes to some switches, and that means only on one input line to your chip, you'll be able to select a lot of different features, because of course this scans through all the different displays, and then when this digit is high, it's selected here, and then this one goes high at the same time as this one, output is high, and so on. So this is a really, really good way to add a lot of features using very little pins. So this is the function input pin, and again, you do exactly the same. So for frequency and period and frequency ratio and time interval and up counter and all those different features it can do. So yeah, it's even done here as well. The different frequency ranges, and it will move the decimal points, and it will do all sorts of things. Yeah, so of course, I'll be able to trace down all the different inputs here and make it read frequencies in this and that mode. And so, yeah, it is possible, definitely possible to get this up and running. And here they say say this is a universal counter. There's also an example of a faster input server where they add some prescaling, and now it can do 40 megahertz frequency counter. So yeah, this is a very interesting chip for simple frequency counters. I didn't really want to say a lot more about this. You can always go and download the datasheet yourself if you want to see a lot more. Thank you.